In Scotland, traditionally, Hogmanay was a much bigger festival than Christmas. Even up until the 1960s, in Scotland, people would work on Christmas Day or a half day on Christmas. Probably goes back to pagan times. Something to do with the winter solstice, and we celebrated the turn of the year. The old year going out, which was quite important, and welcoming in the new year. We have 2 days holiday, the first and second, except if it's on a Sunday, and then we might have the second and third. I think the younger generation go more for Christmas, and the older one for the new year, for Hogmanay, and Nerdy. It would be quite common in the olden days for people to congregate around the cross. Certainly in Glasgow, folk would go to the cross to see in the bells, which is another tradition. You would hear the town bell, and that was the first chime. It'd be the new year, and there would be a big cheer and celebration and a good new year, happy new year and all this stuff. They would burn twigs and flowers and things to smoke out the old new year, smoke out all the bad things that had happened in the old year, purify the house and bring in the new. In Stonehaven they have fireballs. Again it's the same, again it's the winter festival thing about lightening up the darkest days. There was an old tradition, more common in some places, of guising. Now guising, as all Scots will know, is what we do at Halloween. And the Americans call it trick or treat, but it was always guising. When the children would go round and they would perform a poem or a song or a dance, and they would get nuts or fruits or sweets or chocolate or whatever, toffee apples they would get. The same tradition did this at Hogmanay, when kids would go round in that morning and get wee presents from people by doing a turn. Cleaning up the house, ridding up the house beforehand. We would always do it, and my parents would always do it, and in fact I still do it as well. Everything has to be washed and cleaned. Everything has to be washed and cleaned. And all your debts have to be paid off as well. It's really bad luck to go into the new year with debts outstanding. So you'll see a lot of people, again in the older generation, rushing around paying off small debts before that. The other thing that would always happen was you all would phone. If you were far away, you would phone your nearest and dearest to wish them a good new year as well. And certainly when it was only telephone technology, you couldn't get through for 2 hours, you couldn't get a line on the phone, because Scots all over the world were phoning each other. Now they'll be texting and all sorts of other stuff, but that's really nice. I think, certainly in my generation, it's a thing for family and friends. It's a bit of a point, it marks the year, if you like. And you do always think of home, you do, wherever you are, you always think of home.
I think it's growing more and more now, the festivities and the young people now want to go out and celebrate traditionally at Hogmanay.
I think it's a celebration of life, isn't it, in many ways, and of renewal and of hope for the future. No, I haven't made a New Year's resolution for years and years. It's very difficult to keep them. A lot of people give up smoking as a New Year's resolution and go on diets, short diets, because of the new year.